Okay, Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to Madam Ami and also to my fellow classmate. So for individual assignment in core retail anthropology, I'm going to be picking furniture industry, which is I have picked three store, which is IKEA Malaysia, DJ & Co Lifestyle, and also Asylum Store. These three furniture store will be discussing about how it's managing its customer traffic flow, how it managing the crowdedness in the store, and also the service and what facilities that they provided to the disabilities people. So before I explain a little bit more about the three store that I have mentioned earlier, I'm going to be briefly explain about what is furniture industry. So furniture industry is an industry where it produces furniture and fixtures for residential and public areas. As we all know, furniture industry is one of the oldest industry in the world. We can look back at the ancient kingdom where Mesopotamia, Greek, Indians and Persian, where we have the ancient artifacts such as tools, bench, a desk and many more. And we can see in the Middle Age where the furniture has evolved from the ancient kingdom to the Middle Age, where the kings or the queens or the people that have wealth, where they have luxury furniture and many more. So in Malaysia, Malaysia industry furniture were ranked amongst the top 10 largest exporters of furniture in the world. According to Malaysia International Furniture Fair, MIFF 2021, Malaysia export around 80% of its production. So, as we all know, furniture industry is one of the industry that we can see or we can learn about the management of the retailing process more truly. Okay, for the three store that I've mentioned earlier, which is IKEA Malaysia, DJ & Co Lifestyle, and also Ashley Home Store. So the similarities between these three stores, which is they sell furniture. But why did I choose them? It's because although they sell the same product, they also have different weakness, different strength, different facilities that they provided, and also different way on how they managing and controlling the customer traffic flow and also the crowdedness of the store. Okay, for IKEA Malaysia, why do I choose IKEA Malaysia? It's because IKEA Malaysia, as we all know, they have four stores currently in the peninsula of Malaysia, which is the old one will be in the central region, which is in the IKEA Damansara and also in IKEA Ciras. And we also have the Southern Region IKEA store, which is IKEA Terbaru. And the newest one, we have IKEA Kawan Batu in Penang. So the reason why I like this strategic placement store done by IKEA is because this strategic placement benefit both party, which is for IKEA and also for its customer. Because as we all know that a lot of people have been buying or purchasing services and products from IKEA. So if they distribute their store truly in the peninsula Malaysia, not only they benefits their customer, which is if the customer in the particular region before this want to go to IKEA, they have to go to certain region. So by now, if the customer live in the northern region, they can go to the nearest IKEA store, which is in the northern region. And also this making the customer more accessible to the store, and also it is benefit to the IKEA as well. Okay, and then the second reason why do I choose IKEA store, it is because for its price as well. So we all know that IKEA providing low price for its furniture, and this is the main reason why people always go there to come and buy things, or maybe they have a loyal customer because of its pricing. And then low price strategy is also accessible for all types of income as well. with we might see a different kind of a different type of ages and also a different types of household. So different people might say finding things that are suitable for them in IKEA. Since IKEA is a big store and with low price, it also benefits their customer as well. And the third reason of why do I choose IKEA Malaysia store? It is because of its product and services as well. As we all know that IKEA Malaysia store providing a various kind of products and furniture for its customer, which is they are comfortable for all different kind of lifestyle. Some of the customer want a smaller furniture for their small space in house, in their home, and also some of their customer want a bigger furniture or furniture that look extravagant, that look luxurious for their house. And then their services as well. I think IKEA has a good services, which is some of it are commonly being used, such as delivery service, house interior design, and also the assembly service for their customer as well. Okay, so for the second store, which is DJ and Co Lifestyles, the reason why I choose this store is because the first thing is location. I think DJ and Co Lifestyle is currently new to the furniture industry. They started as an e-commerce site in 2014, and then their store is located at Nusa Johor. I think Nusa Johor is strategically placed because it is the largest urban integrated development in the Southeast Asia region, and also the Nusa Johor place is quite near to Singapore, which is provided immense potential for economic growth. So I think it is a good thing that DJ and Co Lifestyle located their store there. The second reason of why do I choose DJ and Co Lifestyle is because DJ and Co is actually a specialty store. They are in-house label, which is space. It is actually a furniture that are designed specifically for small living area. They are also devoted in creating functional item with distinct local identity, and it parts are shipped from European continent to ensure their products are always on the highest quality. And they also have variety kind of product, which is a Murano furniture series, Giyoko wall bed, and also Orzo furniture series under their space as well. So I think the difference between IKEA, because IKEA also providing minimalist furniture, they are specifically designed only for smaller living area. So they have providing a tons of various kind of products for minimalist, which is I think more suitable for minimalist person to choose from, and I think that's what makes them stand out. And the third store, which is actually Home Store. The reason why I choose this store, it is because the location as well. Actually, Home Store is actually located in 5 mall throughout the Peninsula Malaysia, and I think the most famous one it is in Bangi Central and Sita Mall Central in Selangor, and also Kuil City Mall in Kuala Lumpur, and we have the Northern Region Mall, which is in the Gurney Paragon Mall, and in the Southern Region Mall, we have the Top Notch Shopping Mall. These 5 mall is where actually Home Store is located, and I think it's also a good personal store where various kind of customer can come in different region as well. And the second reason of why do I choose actually Home Store is because of its product as well. Actually, store furniture are consisting of mixture of classic and modern furniture design, and from the look from their Actually website, their product appear to be a very high quality material and shows spectacular workmanship. So although the price might a little bit expensive, it is actually worth it with their product as well, because they providing a luxurious look for their product. So I think this is the one main reason why do I choose Actually Home Store. So for this next part, I will be explaining about the customer traffic flow of the three stores will be studied by IKEA Malaysia. So IKEA Malaysia Layout Store is actually a one-way path rather than the usual three path, because I think the design itself actually help to support customer traffic flow and to actually help their customer in self-serve and also to check out more easily. And I think the benefit of this one-way path is actually customer will pass through all the section. So there will be no section that people didn't go there, and this layout actually beneficial to IKEA itself. And also, if somebody might say that, how about if people will get lost in the store? So for that kind of particular reason is why IKEA also guide their customer with arrows and section on the floor as well to assist their customer in shopping. So for the second part will be DJ and Co lifestyle. Instead of using usual layout for furniture store, DJ and Co lifestyle are actually promoting their furniture product by only using showroom layout. And the way that they did that, because the showroom will actually help customer to get an idea about how and where to install the furniture in their house. And for the traffic flow, I think the store is suitable for only maximum 6 people in one period of time, because their showroom is only a bit like a house, like environment. And the reason they did that, because the first thing, they are more to e-commerce site rather than physical store. And the second reason is people we only go there to physically see or to physically hands on the products before buying them, and their customer are only buy through website rather than physical transaction. The third store will be Ashley Home Store. For Ashley Home Store, they're using Avenue Layout Store, because I think Avenue Layout, if when customer entering the store, they see all of it, all of the space and the furniture, and then they are also differentiating their furniture categories by putting it in different spot, such as sofa furniture on the right aisle and the cupboard furniture on the left aisle of the store, and then to make it look systematic and more organized, so their customer will know where to go and finding their preferred furniture. And then for customer flow, they still preserve the one-way path, so customer can go in and out with ease. And their checkout station or pay station are also at the back of the store, so people that just want to look around does not need to bump with customer that want to purchase. And then for in front of the store, they also usually put low price and promotional furniture in front of their store, so people will go there and see and approach their store. And for the third part, I will be explaining the comparison about the size and the crowdedness management of the three store. We'll be starting by IKEA Malaysia. So between the three store, IKEA Malaysia is the biggest store size between the three furniture store, and the aisles is big and organized, so customer can always look around with their own space. And their crowdedness management, they have handled it with efficient with one-way path, which is the one-way path help customer to keep in track and prevent getting lost by following the guided arrows and section, so people know where to go. And then the second store, it is DJ and Co lifestyle, which is between the three stores that I mentioned earlier. DJ and Co lifestyle is the small store size. Their store is only house size store to visualize how the furniture will be installed in the customer house. And the crowdedness management, I think the store is not suitable for the crowded group. It is designed for a small group at one period of time. So, and I think it's okay because, like I mentioned earlier, DJ and Crowdstar are mostly on the e-commerce side rather than physically store. So usually there is not that many of people at one period of time. And then, and the last one is Ashley Home Store, which is the second largest store between the three store that I mentioned. So even though Ashley Home Store is not that big compared to IKEA, but their layout do provide comfortable environment to customer, and people always go in and out without bumping into each other. And then for the crowdedness management, the ice cream store is not as efficient as IKEA, but still deliver good service in terms of managing traffic flow. The store layouts look wide because they are using avenue layout, thus making customer have their own space, and customer can survey or purchase or looking around with ease and without having to bumping into each other. Fourth part will be the accessible with people of disabilities. So in this part, I will be explaining about how the three store providing to their disabilities customer. For IKEA Malaysia, IKEA provided OKU parking, OKU restroom, OKU elevator, OKU lift, braille for product detail, loan wheelchair, hearing loops, and assisting shopping, and many more to assist their customer to the fullest. Which is, I think, IKEA Malaysia also excel in this kind of features. And then the second one is DJ and collab stuff. Other than wheelchair ramp in front of their store, DJ and Kodasha does not provide any of disability facilities. And I think it is due to because they are small store, and it's okay because their small store only provided to a small group of people, so their customer can actually focus to that one particular group and one time. So if there is a disability people are actually go there, their workers will be assisting their customer more efficiently. So the third store will be HT Home Store. Since most of the HT Home Store are in the mall, they actually doesn't need to provide any that much of disabled people facility other than assisting them if they want to purchase or to look around in store, because their store are actually in the mall, so actually their particular mall need to provide those facilities. And Home Store is just one of the store in the mall, so they only need to assist them if they want to buy something in the store. For the last section will be the e-commerce platform, in which on how do these three store actually improving their lack of services by implementing e-commerce in their business. So the first one will be IKEA Malaysia. We all know that IKEA Malaysia also providing e-commerce site to their customer. Like some people might be lazy to go there since IKEA is big, so they are introducing online shopping and delivery to their customer. They can also use a specific kind of apps or a website where people have a map in the phone, because we all know that there always be a new customer every day in IKEA. So people will only go there guiding by the phone, because some people might go there just to buy some small things rather than furniture. And because they are one-way pass, they have to go in, and which is, I think, exhausting. So by using a app with direct ways or some sort of that, people can actually go to the specific kind of place and then pick the item and go to checkout, and people can actually go there without having to go to the entire store. And the second store will be the DJ & Co Lifestyle. Like I mentioned earlier, DJ & Co Lifestyle are mostly on the e-commerce site rather than physically store. But they can also improve their e-commerce site by providing a QR virtual services, where people can actually virtually see on where to put their products in their house rather than need to go to their physical store, which is DJ and Colossal store are only in Johor Bahru. What if the people from Penang want to buy them? So by using virtual services, VR services, they can actually see where to put their furniture in the house by only using VR, which I think is quite an improve facilities in the e-commerce side. Last one would be the HT Home Store. For HT Home Store, they still provided websites and online shopping, but people still need to go there since they offering luxury high quality furniture that are not installable like IKEA or DJ & Co. And although they do have websites and online shopping, but the website is empty. They are not providing enough detail for their customer. So that's the main reason why people still need to go to their store. And I think by providing a great detail on their product, people could only survey in the website and actually purchase in the website, because I think it is more convenient in this era where people are actually buying things from home rather than go to the store like usual. Okay, so that's all from me regarding the video presentation for Retail Anthropology, which is I explaining about furniture industry with three stores, which is IKEA Malaysia, DJ and Co Lifestyle, and also SU Store. So please let me know if you want me to provide additional information regarding this topic, and thank you for lending your time and consideration. Bye bye.